Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. And this morning, April 2023, I wasn't on the big power. I wasn't on the big mainline trains. Now I got called for a local with one engine. Before I could even get on that engine, before I could even get to the yard office to get my paperwork, I had to get by these guys. Usually they mean business. They're here because my conductor feeds them. They won't go away. And I hate them for that. But speaking of locals, recently I caught an SD40 leading a local from Demler to Knoll and back. Now the SD40s are great in some situations, but running one of these long hood forward, it's not the best visibility, and it's not my choice for local power. Sure, it's more powerful than a GP40, but there's a lot of lateral sway, bounces you around. And the visibility running long hood forward is terrible. So in this video, I'm going to talk about my favorite local power and yard job power, the GP40s. So as we see him heading back to Demler, a bunch of scrap from the scrap yard, let's focus on the engines that I prefer. All right, so that's enough with the dramatic intro. But that was fun though, right? So this is a GP, general purpose, four axle engine, locomotive. I'm going to keep calling them engines. Stop criticizing. Go read your comments. There's a lot of criticism about my videos. But as an engineer, we just say, hey, where's our engines at, or where's our power at? Now, what do I like about these? Now, you guys are going to know probably more about the radiator configuration between a GP38 and a GP40. To us, it's pretty much all the same. They can be set up for RCO, that's a remote control operator. If you see a yellow strobe light, if it's flashing, that means it's being run by someone on the ground. That is the conductor, not the engineer. What's wild is you see those electrical cables. If this unit is running as an RCO, we'll just say an RCO unit, you can electrically connect it to the biggest brand new engine and they both will be remote control operated. You do not need an engineer. So this is a GP38-2. The difference between a -2 and a -3, a lot of the -3s now simply have a push button start, which means it can start either by air pressure or electric start. My opinion is the -3s have better toilets. They really went in and put in better toilets, which is going to be in the nose of the engine. So these units, we're going to just say between 2,000. I know it's listed usually as like up to 3,000 horsepower. Not really going to happen. But they're good for switching in the yard. So this is one of my favorite pieces of footage that I got with the drone. Look, you can see the fan spinning on that first unit. And having only one unit is kind of tough for switching. Two units is good because now you have up to 8 axles of independent, that is brake pads against the wheels. But look, they're using 3 engines today. So that gives them 12 axles of independent pressure. It gives them way more horsepower. In this situation, this is RCO, remote control operated. The conductor is on the leading end of the movement, and when he gets about a car length, short of tying onto the cars, he will dismount. RCO guys stay on the outside. There's really no need for them to be in the engine. The roof of the cabs, were painted white to try to keep it cool. Didn't really work, so they put in air conditioners in a lot of these units. The conductor can get off moving equipment at speeds of 4 miles per hour or less, which he does. Notice the fans on the two units compared to the other one. That's just ways you can identify the differences between GP38s and GP40s. When switching and in the yard, the headlight will be on dim. The ditch lights are only needed for road crossings. So he's going to tie onto these cars and start switching. And I hope I give you an engineer's perspective of why we like these for yard jobs and locals. Now, obviously, I haven't been on every type of engine. Definitely not this. But I do try to go to museums and try to film stuff that you might not have seen before. And a lot of the expenses for the traveling, as I do a lot of traveling, is paid with help from Patreon. And I'm so grateful for the Patreon members. At this time, I want to thank some very special ones that joined in the month of April. So I want to give a special thanks to Patreon supporters Ed Randazzo and Joe Michael, Don, and also the Train Freak. You guys can be Patreon supporters by following the link in this video's description. The engineer level will do Zoom calls. The conductor level can maybe help you with a track plan or make a personal video for you, things like that. So check that out in this video's description. I'm so grateful just for all your support. Please be sure to like this video, comment, and if you have social media, share it. YouTube has been acting up, so I can really use your support to keep this video's cranking. All right, so you're probably wondering, what am I doing in the tux? Well, I look smooth, right? Yeah. I went to a black tie affair. I had to actually go on YouTube and figure out how to wear a tuxedo. But it was a black tie salsa event. I had so much fun, and it's all just trying to start a whole new life and make new friends, try new things, and I enjoyed it. There were some women there, too. Ooh, mama. So, yeah, try something different. Just try a different scale. Try wiring. Try ballast. Try weathering. Try something different with your layout. All right, I'm done. Bye. Did you laugh?